not enough vindication for former Senator Leila De Lima. On Monday, the fierce critic of former President Rodrigo Duterte's bloody drug war was acquitted in the last of her three drug cases filed during the Duterte administration. But she says this will never be enough until those responsible for her arrest and detention are held accountable. De Lima maintains the Duterte administration fabricated the drug cases against her.
Nakamit ko yung justicia, nakamit ko yung vindication. Pero gusto ko rin idagdag, hindi pa yan yung pinakakompleto para sa akin. I cannot feel fully vindicated hanggang hindi mapapanagot yung mga responsable sa mga pag-ano nga ng mga kaso na yan. Gusto natin malaman yung katotohanan tungkol sa pag-persecute sa akin. Sino-sino ang mga behind? Bukod alam na natin yan, ang nag-utos niyan yung dating Pangulo dahil sobra nga ang galit sa akin. So it's all for revenge. Ang gusto natin malaman pa, sino-sino pa yung mga trumabaho dun sa operation laban sa akin.
De Lima now eyeing to file countercharges against Duterte and his former officials.
I cannot really disclose yet at the moment yung specific cases. Pero nakatuon yan dun sa malicious prosecution. Na, you know, false prosecution, malicious prosecution. We're also talking about, we're also thinking about yung prosecutorial misconduct nung ilang members ng panel of prosecutors. Iisip pa kami ng iba pa yung ipinag-aaralan po yan ng aking mga abogado. So,
the international community lauding the acquittal of former Senator Leila De Lima on her last remaining drug case. The U.S. State Department welcomes the development and says it continues to work with the Philippines to strengthen democracy and human rights around the world. It also urged Manila to resolve politically motivated cases. European Union Ambassador Luc Veron calling the decision a victory for justice. The Dutch ambassador, meanwhile, says they find inspiration in De Lima's quest for human rights and justice. As for Germany's ambassador, it urges the Philippine government to quickly resolve all cases of extrajudicial killings and to bring perpetrators to justice. Valenzuela City's mayor taking a swipe at his counterparts for allegedly not knowing illegal pogo operations in their towns. Wes Gachalian says it is the responsibility of top local officials to know what is happening inside their territory. Gachalian has banned all pogos and gambling activities in Valenzuela, saying their social costs outweigh their possible economic benefits.
A mayor should know everything that's happening in his city. That's why a job of a mayor is like a GM or a CEO. It's a 24/7 job wherein all aspects of the city, not perfect, but more or less you know. And Pogo right now is a big topic. It's a hot topic. It's a nationwide topic. So this is more, that's why LGUs and mayors should be more vigilant now because of it's not new anymore. As a mayor, you know, we have to safeguard.
Mayor Gachalian also reveals controversial Mayor Alice Go lived with her family in Valenzuela City before becoming the mayor of Bambantarlac.
She lived inside the warehouse.
In Valenzuela.
It's in Barangay Canumay West. The landlord said that they just stayed there for maybe a couple of years, 1 year or 2 years before they moved out. A lot of foreign nationals or Chinese, they move out either to expand their business, to buy other properties. So maybe in the case of the Guo family, maybe Tarlac, they went to Tarlac or to the north. So Valenzuela was just their entry. It's not only the Guo family because this landlord has a couple of properties.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's common for them to have tenants. Oh. They confirmed that the parents first were there in the present. They
set the mother and the father.
And mother and the father and the siblings, the children, were there inside the warehouse.
The ombudsman thumbs down the motion for reconsideration of suspended Bamban Mayor Alice Go, who is accused of being in cahoots with the illegal pogo hub in her town. Robert Mano now joins us with details. Hi, Robert. Tell us more.
Stanley, the office of the ombudsman has dismissed the motion for reconsideration filed by the suspended Bamban Mayor Alice Go, Business Permit and Licensing Officer Edwin Ocampo and Municipal Legal Officer Aiden Tigua, which requested the lifting of the suspension order imposed on the mayor and the two other local officials. According to the Office of the Ombudsman, after careful review, there is no substantial reason to lift the preventive suspension of respondents Go, Ocampo, and Sigwal while the case against them is still under investigation. In the 9-page decision signed by Ombudsman Samuel Martirez, it is stated that although the merits of the case are not being discussed, the Ombudsman reiterates its initial findings that there is official basis to say that there is a strong evidence against respondents Go, Ocampo, and Sigwa at this time due to Go's undeniable business interest in Baupu, as seen in one of the documents, the Tarlac Electric Cooperative Incorporated Statement of Account dated March 8, 2024, in Go's name, which was confiscated on March 13, 2024 during a raid on the Baupu compound related to the alleged human trafficking and serious illegal detention. The Ombudsman also mentioned that the documents are on record show that Baupu and Zun Yuan operate their businesses with permits processed by the BPLO and issued by Go. Furthermore, the Ombudsman added that the documents on record also showed that Sigwa is known to and has previous transactions with Go, as he notarized each deed of absolute sale covering 8 parcels of land previously purchased by Go, which now form the Baupu compound where Hong Shen and Zun Yuan operate. Therefore, the Ombudsman considers it reasonable to temporarily suspend Go, Ocampo, and Sigwa due to their undeniable participation in the operation of Baupu and Zun Yuan. The Ombudsman clarified that a preventive suspension imposed on the three is not a punishment or penalty, but a preventive measure as part of the administrative investigation. Go's camp had earlier requested the lifting of the preventive suspension, arguing that it would not affect the investigation if they continued to serve as the mayor and local officials. They also claimed that there was insufficient basis for the allegations against Go, a point that was countered by the Office of the Ombudsman. And that's the latest from the Ombudsman, Stanley.
Robert Mano, thank you.